10 minutes. It's like,
oh. But yeah, that's like.
Good morning and welcome to Bellamy's Church. Please see today's bulletin concerning upcoming events, as well as a list of members and friends to include in our prayers. It's Bazaar Week. Preparations will be happening throughout the week for the event on Friday and Saturday. If you are able to help out, please see Linda Henny. Lastly, please note the insert in today's bulletin to list names of loved ones to be included in next week's All Saints Sunday service. Thank you for worshiping with us. We are glad you're here.
I thank you for taking time out of your lives to gather this morning for worship on this beautiful, sunny, a little bit brisk fall day. It definitely feels like we are in the heart of the fall season, which usually means, I guess, we're doing something with the bazaar this week, Linda. Something with the bazaar this week? Sure, go ahead. Okay, and then we've got Friday and Saturday, obviously is the bazaar, and even if you can only help out for a couple of hours, we would definitely support, you know, we'll definitely, Linda will tell you where to go and what to do, and as she does with me all the time, it works out really well. And please, you know, anyone that's able to volunteer, even for a little bit, because I know that folks are looking forward to it, so please keep that in mind. And obviously we have the angel tree. And the gift donations will go to Safe Berks. The due date to return gifts is December the 1st. And please put the gifts in gift bags, but please do not wrap them, because they need to make sure that everything is okay. So please just put them in gift bags. So if you'd be interested in doing that, that's there. I also do want to let you know that I will be representing Bellamy's this afternoon at the Covenant Association meeting of the Penn Southeast Conference of the United Church of Christ. So I will be hanging out on Sunday afternoon. So while you're sitting there watching football, I'll be going to a church meeting. But hey, whatever. Are there other joys, concerns, or announcements to be lifted up this morning? We doing okay? Yes, please. Okay. So the Amish history tour of Berks County is taking place next week. Okay. Sounds like a plan. We'll keep an eye out. Okay. Let us now take a moment to prepare our hearts and our minds for worship. And as we gather here this morning on Reformation Sunday, I invite those who are able to please rise as we join in singing our opening hymn, A Mighty Fortress. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. God's love surrounds us every day. Our God is merciful and gracious. Turn your backs upon idols. Worship the Holy One of Israel. Blessed are all who stand in awe before God. Happy are all who walk in His ways. The love of God has called us and unites us with all people. Although God comforts us with abundant mercy, we nevertheless seek to justify ourselves. Let us remember that we, all of us, sin and fall short of the glory of God. Lord of all, you forgive our iniquity and remember our sin no more, and we abuse this freedom as if it were a license to selfishness, self-indulgence, and self-righteousness. You give us the gift of grace, yet we make it cheap without serious repentance. We are your people, but do we know you as our God? Forgive us, Lord, the sins we know in our heart, and save us from the sins that we hide. Amen. Church, through Jesus Christ, God sets us free from our slavery to sin. Your sins are forgiven. And through Christ's death and resurrection, a place is made for us in the household that we may be known as children of God. We rejoice in God's mercy and commit ourselves to renewed faithfulness. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now extend to each other the hand of Christ's peace, as we also extend to it to those who will be worshiping later on at home. Peace be with you. Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, gracious Lord, we thank you that your Holy Spirit renews the church in every age. Pour out your Spirit on your faithful people. Keep them steadfast in your word. Protect and comfort them in times of trial. Defend them against all enemies of the gospel. And bestow on the church your saving peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please go ahead and have a seat.
Good morning. Our first reading today is taken from Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 31 through 34. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. We will read Psalm 46 responsively. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea. Though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult, Selah. There is a river whose streams make glad in the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar. The kingdoms totter. He utters his voice. The earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the Lord. He makes war cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Our second reading is taken from Romans chapter 3, verses 19 through 28. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight by deeds prescribed by the law. For through the law comes the knowledge of sin. But now, apart from law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift, through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Gospel according to St. John, the 8th chapter. I share with you John chapter 8, verses 31 through 36. And then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who commits a sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The Son has a place there forever. So if the Son makes you free, you are free indeed." The Gospel of the Lord. Please go ahead and have a seat as I invite the children to come forward for the children's time, please. Does it work? Oh, those are cool. Thank you. What do you think? Does it work? You like it? Of course, there's only a problem. You know, minions don't wear ties. So, you know, I really got to get rid of the tie because it's not a thing. Do you guys like trick-or-treating? Anybody going trick-or-treating? Oh, yeah. Do you have any costumes? What are you gonna dress up? A witch? Oh, thank you. Anybody else have a costume? What do you got? As Boba Fett. Ooh, kind of scary, huh? Yeah. Anybody else? What do you got? A cow? Anybody else? Yeah. It's fun. Oh, my gosh, this thing's hot. It's fun to play dress-up. It's fun to trick-or-treat. And I know that some of these good folks out here enjoy, you know, a good Halloween party. And sometimes it's fun to pretend that we're something else, to pretend that we're Boba Fett. And you go out and you can – Boba Fett can fly, right? Yeah, that's really cool. Or to pretend that you're a witch and you can go – I don't totally understand the cow thing, but it's all right. But, you know, sometimes we wear a mask and we don't even know it. Sometimes, you know, we think that we have to behave in a certain way or act in a certain way or other people will make fun of us. Sometimes we're afraid, but we feel like we're not able to tell anybody, and so we try to hide. You know, it's important to know that sometimes it's a whole lot of fun to play trick-or-treat, and to wear a mask. But sometimes you have to remember to be yourself and to know that people love you just because of who you are. Okay? Awesome. Should I preach with this? What do you think? Yeah, it'll be kind of hard. Yeah, kind of be hard. Going to be hard for people to pay attention with this. So I'll hang on to it for right now. And we do have our jingle offering today. And that, again, will be going to folks that are having a really hard time right now and need some help because of the hurricanes. And so can you guys help me out with that? And can you help out, too, with that, please?
Thank you.
Thank you for helping out. Appreciate it. Can we have a quick word of prayer? Okay. Dear God, we thank you for creating us and for making us wonderful just as we are, that we don't need to wear a mask because you know us by name and we are yours. We love you, God. Amen. Thanks a lot, guys. Go ahead and have a seat. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Here, hold it. Let us pray. Dear Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. If we've got red on the altar, it means that something's going on. And today we celebrate Reformation Sunday. And I know that it's kind of hard to remember something that happened several hundred years ago. But remember that Reformation Sunday was when Martin Luther made a decision that the church that he served was not the church that he wanted it to be. And so he took a risk, he took a chance, and he made some changes. And so I find it very, very interesting that as we gather here on Reformation Sunday and we celebrate an event that happened centuries ago, we're celebrating an event that deals with religion, politics, power, courage, and change. So what's happening in 9 days? You're allowed to talk back. Really, this is church, but you're allowed to talk. In about 9 days. Now, I remember when Halloween used to be the scariest day of the year. But, and of course, having the beauty of living in the state of Pennsylvania, I think the happiest person right now is my mailman, because he at least has something to do as he's bringing all of those flyers. And I'm not sure what the TV commercials are going to advertise after next Tuesday, because it's been blowing up and I'm getting the stuff on my phone. I don't know if you're getting the stuff on yours. It's the beauty of being in what they call a swing state. But the anxiety levels right now, I think, are pretty high with the political parties and world events and the powerful issues that we're dealing with in our own country. And I know that there's probably a couple of you that are sitting there getting ready to put your hands over your face going, geez, he's been here a month. 2 weeks ago he talked about money, and now he's going to talk about politics. Well, got to start out with a definition. Y'all know the definition of politics? You know what the word means? If you break it down, okay, poly, what does poly mean? Many. Ticks. Those little things that latch on and suck. Forget it. For our sake and for our understanding of God, I'm going to talk a little tiny bit today about politics. But I'm not here. Stop. I'm not going. How does that thing go at the bottom of the commercial? This message is not presented by any candidate or party. No. I'm simply saying, first off, vote. Please go and vote. It is incredibly important. But what I want to offer to you in this time, as we're struggling, I think, with some anxiety as a nation about what is coming, that our Bible does help us with how we are to be faithful, especially in disagreement in this time. And it starts by knowing where your true citizenship lies. Okay, I live at 9624 Ponderosa Court, Kempton, Lehigh County, State of Pennsylvania, United States of America, planet Earth. But I am first a citizen of the kingdom of God. That my responsibility first is to God. And I need to know who it is that I serve. How's the hymn go? I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. He is who I serve. And that is where my allegiance lies. We've been hearing a lot, a whole lot, in the mail and on the TV and in all the advertisements about freedom and what freedom actually means. But what freedom truly means is given to us in John chapter 8. If you continue in my word, you are my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. If the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed. My freedom is not given, and it cannot be taken away by any party or any power, that my freedom comes from God. And that being said, I pray that we remember that we are in this together. Regardless of where you're at, we are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and the hymn says, we pray that all unity will one day be restored. Why is it bad to have a politician on your airplane when you're flying? Any guesses? $5 if you know the answer. Anybody know the answer? Why is it bad to have a politician on the airplane that you're flying on? Because they're always trying to destroy the other wing. Dreadful. However, true. And we are flying together. Regardless of whether we agree or disagree, destroying the wing is not the way to fly. And we have to hold fast to recognizing that we are one nation and that we are trying our best together. Another piece that our Bible tells us, God will still be God regardless of who gets elected. On November 6th or 7th or 8th, or 10th, or whenever we find out who the next president is. God will still be God. And no matter who gets elected, we have a responsibility as faith-filled people to seek justice, love kindness, and walk with humility, as it says in the prophet Micah, to keep doing what we are doing and to build up both the body of Christ and this country. If you remember, in all of the politicking that we've been subjected to, each political party has a platform. It is a statement on what they believe. But what I want to offer to you is a statement on what I pray that you believe, especially as we journey into difficult times. And I want to share with you a little bit out of Romans chapter 12, where Paul writes to you and to me, hate what is evil, cling to what is good, be devoted to one another in love, honor one another above yourselves, be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer, share with God's people who are in need, practice hospitality. Paul continues, be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone, and if it's possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. If your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he's thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head. And church, do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. I pray that's what we take. I pray that's what we carry. But I also know that this is not easy, because we are conditioned to act in a certain way. We are conditioned to respond in a certain way. A Democrat and a Republican walk into a bar. No, really, that's the joke. Because it doesn't happen anymore. Because we have gotten to the point where we're not even dialoguing with each other. We're not even communicating with each other. We're screaming over each other. You remember the first sermon I preached I talked a little bit about my puppy. Okay? My puppy, her name is Penny. Penny is cute. She's wonderful. However, she doesn't listen. And I think that she doesn't listen because she's a bad dog. But no, she doesn't listen because she's got no stinking clue what I'm actually saying. Penny, sit. Penny, sit. Penny, sit! And the beauty of it is, we think that if we just scream louder, that they'll understand. Church, it doesn't work with my dog. And it certainly doesn't work with people that we are struggling to understand, with people that we are struggling to listen to, with people that we have been journeying with for decades and perhaps believe a little bit differently than we do about the future of the nation. And so we decide then that they're wrong and they're going to be wrong, and we'll just keep them being wrong, and we'll say that they're wrong even louder. But we won't take the time to listen. We won't take the time to hear what other people are saying. We won't take the time to communicate. We are being divided as a nation. Each one of us needs to decide to make a choice, whether we will buy into the rhetoric and the chaos and the fear-mongering, or whether we can decide that we will do better and we can be better. We need to hold each other up and support each other strong. Okay? I was old enough to remember when they had civics class in high school. Do they still have civics class in high school? They do. Awesome. Good. Now, you're going to help me with this, okay? Because we're in this together, and you're going to help me with this. Now, I remember this, because it goes a little bit like this. One nation under, wow, not under candidate, not under party. One nation under. And what's the next word? Indivisible. Friends, that's my prayer. Because we're teetering. But it's my prayer that we remember that we are one nation under God, indivisible. Oh, and good heavens, with liberty and with justice, not for a few. With liberty and justice for all. We are journeying into this time, and I think our country needs to see a model of people who can disagree, but who recognize that we've got a greater plan, a greater purpose. We are under God first, and we have a responsibility as believers in His Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We have a responsibility to build up our communities, to do justice, love kindness, to walk with, oh my gosh, humility. And recognize that we are all in this together. Thanks be to God. And at this time, I will encourage those who are able to please rise as we profess our faith together. In response to hearing God's word for us, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Gracious and loving God, we lift these, our gifts, up to you now. We ask that you would receive them and bless them, that your word of promise and hope might be spread throughout the world. God, we truly need to have your word of hope spread through our communities and through our nations and through this world. Because, God, we know that you are the God who created the heavens and the earth. But we also know that as your children, we are struggling. We are struggling to maintain the beauty of this planet. We are struggling to recognize that we are supposed to live at peace with all. We are struggling to remember that even in disagreement, that we are one body, one spirit in Christ. God, there are a lot of people who are having a hard time right now. We ask that you would strengthen us as your church to be the ones that promote peace and liberty and justice, to be the ones that feed the hungry and clothe those who have no clothing, that provide a cup of cold water to a little one, that we would be the ones who model the behavior that we feel all should carry. And we can do this not because we're wonderful or not because we say the right words, but we can do this because you love us and you redeem us and you strengthen us. And when we find our grounding in you, we then can share the message of hope and promise with other people. And God, we ask you to hear us as we join our lips with our hearts. Pray the prayer that Jesus taught as we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. My friends, it's time to go out into this world. This world's a little bit hostile. Everybody seems a little touchy. But as we go forth, we recognize that we will be slow to anger. We will be slow to speak. We will be quick to listen. And we might be the ones who are able to proclaim God's word of hope and peace. And so may the blessing of Almighty God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit be upon you. May God's blessing remain with you forever and ever.
Foundation is Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus, new creation, by water and the Word. To be his holy bond, with his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, yet one for all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food, and to one hope she presses with every grace and dues. Mid toil and tribulation and tumult of her woe, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore, till with the vision glorious her longing eyes are blessed. Great Church victorious shall be the Church at rest. Yes, she on earth hath union with God the Three in One, and mystic sweet communion with those whose grace is ours.
Church, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.